The air box or air chest was fabricated to contain additional air at pressure for when you're testing pipes, especially the larger pipes. All the interior was varnished to make it as airtight as possible, and this will connect to the box that has the bellows and the reservoir. The lid for the box was taped off on the perimeter. I didn't want varnish on here because I wanted glue to stick to this area. This will be sealed to the box, glued down, and sealed. There'll be a couple of holes drilled in here, and the valve assembly mounts on top of this. The bellows and reservoir box is a sealed box, with the exception of the air intake holes on this side. The motor cooling fan draws air in through here, blows it across the motor. Some of that air is taken in by the bellows, and the remaining air comes out these exhaust holes. The air box is raised in this section so the air can exhaust from underneath the box. And the reservoir is connected to the air box with a piece of hose. Making a little assembly for the valves. Sometimes it's easier to notch these out so everything indexes together. Somewhat self-squaring, not exactly. But if you're careful, you can glue that together and it'll remain square. And then I have access for my valves later on from the bottom. If I need to work on this, I get to the two screws that attach it and the spring will be over here. Butt this up against the fence. Put some glue in the slots. Top piece in. The valve assembly in. Put that on there. Check it for square, a couple of clamps. Let it dry. All these pieces have been glued together. I used carpenter's glue to put a fillet of glue in all these corners to make sure it was sealed to be airtight. And all surfaces were painted with a mixture of glue and water. This surface was given a couple of coats of varnish and then sanded smooth. And that's where this little leather valves will be sealing against that surface. I have these push buttons on here. These are made from an axle cap for a wood toy. They're made for a 1/4 inch dowel. I glued a 1/4 inch dowel in there and then re-drilled it for this 1/8 inch piece of bamboo skewer. There's a washer on the top and bottom of a spring, and that spring is out of a ballpoint pen. Internally, there's a wood collar glued onto this bamboo skewer to keep it from flying out of there if you let go of it like this. And that skewer pushes open this leather valve. And once that's open to pressure, the end of that skewer becomes a piston. And it's quite possible for air pressure to push that all the way out of there. So that wood collar keeps it locked in place. This end has been sealed up with a piece of plywood, and I used a little extra thickness on plywood here because our tubing is just a pressed fit into those holes. That's all that holds that in there. And that's the same for the pipes. The tubing just presses into a hole in the pipes as well. Have the flapper valves and the closing springs installed. These springs are enough to keep those sealed. This is exactly the same thing that's the relief valve on the reservoir. The springs are holding these closed. This is on the pressure side, so you have the air pressure that helps keep these closed as well. When I push on one of these valve openers, or one of these rods, that rod opens that flapper valve. And opens it quite a bit, should be more than enough. And you can see it from this side. I haven't closed this up yet. You can see it operating like that. And just to review, the air box is down here. The flapper valve prevents the air from getting into these two chambers. When I push this down, it opens the valve and allows air to go into one of these two chambers, which are connected to one of these two hoses. So when I push this, I'm opening air, which will blow a pipe for testing. The top of the air box has been given two coats of varnish, sanding between coats to seal the wood and to give the leather gasket something to seal against. Now we'll attach the valve box to the top of the air box. That's one of the lowest tone pipes on the Busker. It's a B flat. That's the highest tone. That's a D. Now we're hooked up to the manometer. If I open that up, we can see we're running at 5 inches of water. When I press the low tone B flat, it doesn't drop the pressure very much, and the lowest tone pipes take the largest amount of air.